We'll now mention another external sorting algorithm, which we call multiway merge. Let's suppose we have extra tapes. We can actually reduce the number of passes that we need to perform the sort. So we extend our basic merge, which is a two-way merge, into what we call a k-way merge. So think about what happens whenever we're merging with two runs. So we just find the minimum of two tapes, we then add it to the output, and then we just advance the appropriate tape. That's all we're doing when we're trying to merge two runs. Now, if we have k tapes, that means we need to find a minimum of k runs. Now you might think, well, we could just take a look at each run and pick the minimum one, but that doesn't seem very efficient. So there is another data structure we can use, which is called the priority queue. Now we'll talk more about priority queues in the data structures course, but the idea of a priority queue is we would structure the values such that to find the minimum value, it only takes constant time. Now there's different ways that we can implement that, but we're just saying we can structure our data such that finding the minimum value takes constant time. We then need to be able to remove that minimum value. So there are a couple ways we can implement it. We can use an ordered or sorted array. We can also use what's called a tree. And we talked a little bit about that very early in the semester, and we'll be talking a lot more about trees in our data structures course. So we can use this priority queue data structure for dealing with multiple runs and trying to merge sort those. So what we do here is whenever we advance the respective tape, then if the run on that tape isn't done, then what we need to do is take the new element that's on that run and add it to the priority queue. And that queue will take care of giving us the minimum value. So we pick it, add it to our output tape, and then we just repeat this. So all we're saying here is instead of just taking two runs and then merging them onto another tape, we can have k runs and merge them together into a single tape. And we just use this priority queue data structure to handle finding the minimum value each time. So how many passes is this going to take since we are trying to make improvements here? Well, remember, we still have that initial run construction phase where we're breaking up our data into sorted runs, but the number of passes is going to be the ceiling of log base k of n over m before we had the ceiling of log base 2 of n over m. So what we're saying here is the run is going to get k times as large with each pass because we have additional tapes that we're reading. So if we go back to our earlier example, let's say we have three input tapes instead of two input tapes. That means we're going to have the ceiling of log base 3 of 13 over 3. And this turns out to be two additional passes, whereas if we had just the two input tapes, we would have the three additional passes that we had from before. We'll now take a look at what we call the polyphase merge. Now, there is a problem with the k-way merging strategy that we just talked about. And the problem is we need 2k tapes, which may be unrealistic for us. So what we're saying here is we actually only need k plus 1 tapes instead of 2k tapes. So we're going to talk about two different ways that we can go about doing this. The first approach is that we put all the runs into k tapes, and then we merge all those into the original tape. Remember, we're trying to do this with only k plus 1 tapes. So we put all of our runs into k tapes and then put them all back into just one tape. So that's how we get the k plus 1. Now the thing here is since all of the runs are on just one tape, we then break up those runs into k minus 2 remaining tapes. Now why is it k minus 2? Because once we've done that, that means that we have two tapes left over, which means then we can just merge as normal, where we can put stuff from the two tapes there, and then we would have plenty of tapes left over to merge stuff into two more tapes. So now we can just go back to our original approach. We just needed to use the tapes from before to do that initial breaking up and then merging. The second approach is we can actually split the runs unevenly. So the idea is as we finish one tape, we'll rewind that tape because we can start from that tape again, and we'll also rewind the merged tape. So then we would actually use the finished tape as the merging destination. So what we do is we, as we clean up one tape, we have one tape spare, we're going to use it as a destination for the remaining merges. So we would rewind the merge tape, start from there, and use the other tape that has not completed its merging part, but we'll just start merging our sorted merge tape with that tape, and we just continue on. And then the second tape is going to be freed up, so then we'll rewind that tape with the other merge tape, and we just keep repeating this until everything is sorted.